With the assistance of the outside broadcast unit, we will be linking from the database studio to their home. Pat Green and Julian, welcome to database.
Hello, Jane.
Hello, Jane.
Now, Julian, I see you have your computer linked to the telephone line. Can you tell us how you did that?
Yes, well, it's very simple, really. The telephone is connected to the telephone network with a British Telecom plug, and I simply remove the telephone jack from the telecom socket and plug it into this box here, the modem. I then take another wire from the modem and plug it in where the telephone was. I can then switch on the modem and we're ready to go.
What is CalSAWS? CalSAWS stands for the California Statewide Automated Welfare System. It will house all 58 California counties and replace the existing C4, LRS, and CalWIN systems. Per federal mandate, CalSAWS unites all of California's 58 counties under one roof. It streamlines functions and provides users with a seamless experience that is secure and easily accessible.
Hi, Albert Richardson, Staff Service Analyst and Change Network Champion for Colusa County Health Human Services. So here's about five things that are to be expected coming up in CalSAWS. Number one, so there's going to be updated imaging. So you're going to be allowed to scan multiple cases, and CalSAWS will have barcodes that will take those scanned documents and route them directly to the cases, no more having to scan and scan and scan and then personally upload the documents. There's also going to be an updated homepage that's going to have a lot more information about scheduling and case information for managers. There's going to be homeless assistance. In addition to HSP, there's going to be other housing program information added to CalSAWS. And then there's also going to be a lot of automation and flagging and task management. If there are any troubled or any cases or any processes in which CalSAWS is identified as troublesome or have a lot of errors in them, there will be flags letting you know that, hey, what you're about to do potentially might be a little challenging. And then there's just a lot more detail overall to provide to employees and to give to customers.
Hi, I'm Adriana Costa, Eligibility Specialist in Colusa County. I'm most excited about the new system, CalSAWS, because of ICTs will be easier, we'll be able to help the customers better, counties will be able to communicate better, and I'm just excited of the new changes.
CalSAWS is being built by the CalSAWS Consortium and vendor partners working hand-in-hand with counties.
My name is Daniel Witherell, a.k.a. Dan Dan the Welfare Man. I work for UC Davis, continuing professional education. We provide training and instruction for eligibility workers all over the state of California. CalWORK, CalFresh, Medi-Cal, CMSP, interviewing fraud, those are the things I do for UC Davis. Been there for 30 years. I've been in eligibility now for a little over 36 years. I started as an eligibility worker one for Siskiyou County on March 5th of 1985. I spent altogether a little less than 10 years with the county. I was an eligibility worker one for about 6 months, was a two for about a year. Was an eligibility worker three for about a year after that. And at the ripe old age of 25, I was the eligibility supervisor in charge of training. That led to training with UC Davis, which started in 1991. I've trained for them ever since. Trained the implementation of systems like the interim statewide automated welfare system starting back in 1994. Also worked with counties in the implementation of CalWIN and LEADER. The system and process of eligibility has changed significantly in the time that I've spent there. I started in a system that was all manual, pen, paper, one computer in the entire office, the meds terminal. We all shared the same password, the same ID. The med system would only update once a week after we sent the magnetic tape to Sacramento on a Greyhound bus. So the implementation of the automation projects, which actually started in the late 80s, early 90s with NAPIS and MAGIC, which eventually became the ISAS system. Eventually we moved on, you know, from having two systems to having one system, having four systems, down to three systems, and hopefully here pretty soon having a couple of systems or just one system statewide. A little bit about transforming the food stamps from actual coupon benefits to the EBT card. As we were switching to the EBT system, I actually facilitated a lot of the statewide meetings that we had with stakeholders, getting partners and people in the system together, getting everyone adjusted to moving beyond the paper coupons into the electronic benefit transfer system. Today, I find that I've had to adjust a lot of the training that I do specifically in the area of fraud to adapt to new methods of fraud and abuse that occur with the EBT card versus what we used to train with the paper coupon system. During the migration of ISAS to the C4 system, primarily I stayed away from the change in the automation system and tried to keep workers grounded in that there were no changes to eligibility. One of the things that I tend to kind of preach often that people have heard me say a lot is, you know, the eligibility is the eligibility regardless of the system. And to make sure as eligibility professionals that we, you know, determine eligibility based on what the eligibility rules and regulations are rather than what may or may not be coming out of the system. So in other words, letting the eligibility drive what the system does rather than letting the system drive what you think the eligibility should be. So during the migration to C4, there was a great deal of confusion in some areas, things that C4 did differently, which led to discussions about program interpretation and how we were going to do things going forward. The thing I'm most excited about with CalSAWS is the thought of actually having one system statewide. I actually held in my hand in 1992 a 57 county implementation schedule for the SAWS system. The original concept was a statewide automated welfare system that everybody would have, everybody would work. So I'm excited to see, although almost 30 years later, or actually I guess by the time we're done a little over 30 years, it will be somewhat satisfying for me to actually see that come to fruition. The benefits of having a statewide system I think are enormous, both from the increased consistency in program implementation,
Hopefully counties will come together and start to do things a lot more the same than the way they do them now. The other thing I think is exciting is for eligibility professionals to be more mobile, to be able to move more freely and easily between counties to take advantage of career opportunities. That, of course, has always been a little harder to do when you have to start over, not only just in a new county, but in a new system. Having everybody on the same system should make it easier for people in the eligibility profession to follow those career aspirations, whether they lead to, you know, management or in another county, or moving on to CDSS or DHCS. You know, having everybody on the same page in the same system will be a real positive for the eligibility staff that work so hard all over the state.
This migration into the CalSAWS system is a historic step in the history of California's public assistance. We thank all of you for your work and your dedication in serving the public of the state of California.
Waiting for the computer to answer me.